attended the Bible school, and today we're going to take a journey through the Book of Samuel and learn about one of my favorite stories. So let's get started. One of God's servants, Samuel, was told by God to find a man named Jesse, for I have provided myself a king amongst his sons. So Samuel hurried along, obeying God's command. Jesse had 7 of his sons to pass by Samuel, but none was found to be the chosen one of God. So Samuel asked Jesse, "Are there any other sons you have not told me about?" Jesse looked at Samuel and said, "There is one, but he's my youngest son. He watches the sheep. Surely he can't be the chosen one." Do you feel sometimes parents, teachers, and even your friends treat you as if you are too young, too small, not strong enough, you're not ready to handle a big task? In Matthew chapter 19, verse 14, the Bible reads, "And Jesus said, suffer little children, and forbid them not to come unto me, for of such is the kingdom of heaven." Jesus believed all children are able to do big and great things, not in their strength, but in his. I can do all things, and you can do all things in Christ who strengthens us. Philippians chapter 4, verse 13. After Jesse brought David into Samuel, the Lord told Samuel to arise and anoint David because he was truly the chosen one, and the Spirit of God fell upon David, that little shepherd boy. Is there truly such a thing as giant people? Are people walking around today with heights as tall as the Empire State Building? Okay, I'm exaggerating. Well, maybe a lot. Yes, we do have giants in the world, but not like the giant that David will go up against. King Saul and the Israelites had a battle with the Philistine soldiers. The Philistines stood on a mountain on one side, and the Israelites stood on a mountain on the other side of the land, which had a great big valley between them, and all of a sudden, it happened. Remember I asked about giants of the land? Well, the Philistines had won. And in today's time, it's known as a ring. Goliath was his name, standing at an estimated 9 feet and 6 inches, standing in the midst of the valley. He cried out, "Choose you a man for you, and let him come down to me. If he be able to fight with me and to kill me, then I will be your servant. But if I prevail against him and kill him, then shall ye be our servants and serve us." Goliath had all the Israelites afraid. Even King Saul was shaken with fear. And no one Israelite was brave enough to go up against the Philistine giant. One day, David heard much talk of the Israelites being afraid of the Philistine giant, and it saddened him much. So David, remembering God, began to speak. "Who is this Philistine that he should defy the armies of the living God? Let no man's heart fail because of him. I will go fight with this Philistine." Before the battle, King Saul tried to give David armor to fight Goliath, but David chose only to use his sling and 5 rocks. As David approached for battle, Goliath laughed at him and said, "Come to me, and I will give thy flesh unto the fowls of the air and to the beasts of the field. Ha ha ha!" Then David, the little shepherd boy, love and fear God, said, "You come to me with a sword, spear, and a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God you defy. This day will the Lord deliver you into my hands, and I will kill you, and all the earth will know that there is a God in Israel." Then David fired a stone from his sling right into Goliath's forehead, and the giant Philistine fell to the ground and died. And the Israelites gained the victory through a young shepherd boy that God anointed and blessed. I want to leave you with these words. In David, we see a young boy who was willing to serve God, and through his service to God, he was able to show the Israelites that God has not forsaken them. But with their spirit of fear and lack of trust in God, God wasn't able to use them in the fight. As a child, you won't be fighting any mighty battles, but you will be used to show others the mighty works of God as He lives, breathes, and works in your life as you grow. So be faithful and trust in God. Until next time, I'm Kendrick the Bible Explorer!